It's me, XC Visions, and I'm back with my boy Anthony. The last time y'all saw him, he took that L.
Man, come on now. Not even right.
Oh yeah, I still owe you a rematch, bro.
Yeah, you gotta do it. I'm gonna win this time. Bust it up. What you mean? But we can do that today.
Alright, bro, we going to the... Me and Demir going to the, to peak anyway.
I bet.
I gotta see how many guest passes I can use them. But no. Anyway, so we here with another story time. You know, I only did one of these story times before. So if you didn't watch that last one, go watch it right now. So anyway, this is the story about me and Anthony getting jumped by some niggas on the block. Some niggas on the block. No, he was like 14 or 15 years old.
Young as fuck.
And like now we're like 19, so this happened like 4 or 5 years ago. But anyway, yeah, so you know, we live on the west side. And if you know anything about Rockford and the west side, you know you're either gonna get jumped, shot, stabbed, robbed. Something bad is guaranteed to happen to you.
Something's gonna come down.
Something. Like, there's no...
There's no in between, there ain't no safe spots, there ain't shit.
You're gonna, something's bad gonna just happen to you, bro. That's just how it is. Like, I can't even tell you how many times that we experienced some stuff over here.
No, my bad luck too.
Yeah, he got the worst out of like all of us.
Yeah, no times I've been jumped.
That's a story for a different day. Anyway. So, we're gonna tell you the story about the time we got jumped, and Andy's gonna start it off, and I'll be jumping in, and then we're just gonna continue from there.
Right? So, we was at Henrietta, this little park.
So, is this school on the west side called Henrietta, and is it a middle school?
No, it's like a Head Start.
Yeah, it's like a Head Start school for like all the little bad kids or whatever, bad like that.
Those so, bad west side kids.
Yeah, the little bad Westside kids, they used to go over there, so. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was our hangout spot, you know, for our squad. We used to stay over there. And so he's gonna continue.
Alright, so when we was at the park, we was making these little crop circle things up in the wood chips. Like, we was being some, like, I don't know why we was doing it, it was just something we was just doing. Like, so, we was bored.
Yeah, so like the crop circles, they were like, yeah, I know what crop circles are, like, how aliens be dropping down and then be making these circles in the field and stuff like that. But we was making it with our feet, you know what I mean? Like in the wood chips, we like drag our feet and make a whole bunch of circles and a bunch of stuff like that. So that's what we was doing.
Yeah, so we was just doing that and then, well, we seen Quisha come through.
Yeah, so this is not her real name. We're not gonna use a real name for privacy purposes. So I don't get sued or no dumb stuff like that. So yeah, so we're just gonna call her Quisha from now.
Hey, Quisha.
Let's go.
Yeah, well, we was talking to Quisha.
Hey.
For real though? But yeah, we was talking to Quisha and
Hey.
And
Onyx, shut up.
That dog don't like me. All right. But yeah, we was talking to Quisha, you know, we was seeing what's up with her and everything. So we started, she asked us to go to the store?
Yeah.
Yeah, she asked us to go to the store. So, you know, we just walking with her to the store. And the store, like, right up the street, it's like...
So it's this store on the west side, you know what I'm saying? You from here, you already know what it's called. It's called Allmart.
Yeah.
It's closed now, you know. It's hood. And a bunch of hood niggas is just coming through, ruining things for us. Like that, like back then, like we didn't have no money or anything like that. So like every time we got hungry, we either go to the Candy Lady, or we go to Walmart up the street from our house, from our neighborhood.
I miss that Candy Lady though.
Yeah, we had the plug on the Candy Lady.
Man, I think she liked me low key.
Probably did.
Man, she was always giving me free shit.
I didn't get free nothing, bro. I probably get like free slushies or something like that.
No. I remember one time she gave me free, what was it, barbecue fries?
Anyway, yeah, bro, like, all that Candy Lady stuff, like, that's not on the west side no more. Like, the west side changed so much. Like, it's always dead.
Ain't like, nothing here no more. Like,
everybody moved, and all the fun moved away. Now we just doing stuff outside the West Side.
Yeah. Shit. So we was going to the store with Quisha, and you know, we stopped at her house, and then she went to the store because her house was like right next to the store. So we waited until she got out, and you know, she came up, and you know, we was talking to her. So, you know, go ahead.
Yeah, we was talking to her, see what she was on, you know what I'm saying? Because we went to school with her, and, you know, we was just friends with her, you know, we was trying to see what was up, you know what I'm saying? If she's down to do some stuff that we're not going to talk about.
That's
now,
the word.
You know what I'm saying? You already know how we got down. We was not playing no games with these females. But anyway, yeah, so we was trying to see what she was on. And then all of a sudden, five niggas came coming up the block. Now, if you from the West Side or you from any hood, you know that any niggas walking down the street and you alone, you should just run because you already know they on something. Like, they ain't just gonna be like, how's your day? It's going great. All right, see you next time. No.
Looking at, no, that shit dead.
You about to get jumped. You about to get robbed. You about to... Something bad is bound to happen. Like, five niggas and you is a bad combination.
It's a real bad combination.
Because now they feel like they can do whatever they want to you. You know what I mean? You're vulnerable. So it was 2 against 5, right? But, I mean, we're going to get to that later.
Okay.
But, so this is what happened. So it was me and Anthony and Quisha. And we was in Quisha's yard, right? So we were at her house, we was outside. So the niggas came up, and they was like, hey, you with the braids. I had braids back then at the time. So, you know, me and Anthony, we already knew what was up. Like, we not dumb. We already knew that they was on some. We couldn't run because them niggas was older than us. It was like, what, like 17, 18 or something like
somewhere
that?
Around that. Like,
we was like 14 years old.
Like, small as fuck, too. They was like up there.
Right, so we couldn't run, we couldn't fight them because obviously we was gonna get outnumbered.
Yeah.
So we was stuck. We had to do what they say. So
had to do what we had to do.
So we go up there and we walk, and then so you gonna tell what he said?
Oh, shit. So this what he said, right? He was like, "So how y'all know my sister?" I'm like, "You know, I knew her from you know way back." You know, then Xavier was like, "Well, what you say?"
I just agreed with you.
Yeah,
I'm like, we know her for knew her in school and stuff like that, you know, just trying to make it
seem like we wasn't on shit.
Right. Yeah. Make it seem like we just neighborhood friends. No, we just trying to get that sloppy talk.
Yeah, it's goofy.
Nah, I'm just
But then when we said that, I was like, I might know you because I used to live across the street from Quisha, you know, when we was little work and shit. So he was like, "Nah, I don't
you
know."
He was straight lying. He was straight lying.
Look, I wasn't trying to get my ass beat, okay?
He's like, "I remember you, bro. Down the street, remember, bro." Nah, he did not know
shit.
That. So anyway.
Yeah, and then he was talking about some other shit. And then this was a time when I had glasses, you know. Nigga can't see right now. But, you know, me and Xavier just sitting there, you know, boom.
And then, guess what these niggas asked us to do?
Never in my life.
Just guess! They said, out of nowhere.
Strip.
Matter of fact, strip. I'm not going for that!
Hell no. Me and Xavier just looked at each other like...
I was like, nah, I'm not stripping. I don't care what's about to go down.